Hey guys, welcome to this video over measuring nuclear radiation. Radiation can affect people in various ways and can even result in death. Because of this effect, we must be able to measure the amount of radiation present. There are two things you need to be aware of when making radiation calculations: decay and half-life and source strength. Radioactive decay, also commonly known as radioactivity, is a set of processes that allows unstable atomic nuclei, or nucleides, to emit radiation. This happens randomly and cannot be predicted. However, on a larger scale, radioactive material does behave in a way that is possible to predict. Radioactive decay always occurs at an exponential rate. The amount of radioactive material N present after time t is given by the equation N equals N sub 0 times E to the lambda times T, where N sub 0 is the amount of material present at time T equals 0, and lambda is the decay constant of the material. The time required for half of the mass of a radioactive material to decay is known as its half-life. Half-life is the most commonly used measure of a material's rate of decay, and it can be short as a fraction of a second or as long as millions of years. If the half-life of the material is known, lambda, the decay constant, can be calculated as lambda equals ln 2 over t sub 1 half, where t sub 1 half is the half-life. For example, suppose a sample of radium-224 starts at a mass of 10 grams. Its half-life is 3.63 days. The remaining mass of radium-224 after 8 days can be calculated by lambda equals ln2 over 3.63 days equals 0.191 disintegrations per day. This source strength of a radioactive material is defined as the number of disintegrations per second and is measured in becquerels or curies. One becquerel is one disintegration per second. One curie is 3.7 times 10 to the 10 disintegrations per second. Source strength is given by the equation Q equals lambda times M times N sub A all over W, where Q is the number of disintegrations per second, lambda is the decay constant, M is the mass of the radioactive isotope, N sub A is Avogadro's number, which is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd grams per gram atoms. W is the atomic weight of the radioisotope. For example, if radium-224 has a decay constant of 2.0289 times 10 to the negative 6 disintegrations per second, and an atomic mass of 224.02, a 5.8 times 10 to the 12th becquerel source of radium-224 can be calculated to have a mass of M equals Q times W over lambda times N sub A, which equals 3.8 times 10 to the 12th times 224.02 over 2.2089 times 10 to the negative 6 times 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, which equals 640 micrograms. I hope that this video is helpful. For further help, be sure to check out our other videos right here. See you next time.